Everybody, welcome back. We're down to 24 hours with the 1421, so it's time to give you guys our review and the things that we learned about running a 21 series grain cart that Kenzie brought us this fall to share with you guys. If it's your first time here to the YouTube channel, I'm Ben Van Ruckel. I'm a 29-year-old second-generation farmer. I farm with my father, Scott, and we farm in the bottom counties of Southern Iowa. This fall, we ran the Kenzie Harvest Commander 1421. And unfortunately, no, it was not pulled with the Kenzie Repowered 8630 this fall. It was pulled with the 535 quad track. Yeah, I know it's still a little bit dirty, but I was actually instructed not to clean it up before I send it back. On the farm, we do come from a lineup of Kenzie grain carts, but the Kenzie grain cart we usually pull around is significantly older than this one right here behind us. It's actually a Kenzie 1040 grain cart, and we've used it for as long as I can remember. Which gives you guys an idea of what we're used to using and what we've come to really like using. This year in Southern Iowa, we harvested more acres than we've ever harvested on our farms. And we were blessed with some really great yields, record-setting yields down here, which was setting us up for the chance to really have a prolonged harvest. Because we did not upgrade any of our harvest equipment. Same combines, same headers. The only thing that different that showed up was the Kenzie 1421. And I honestly thought with this grain cart right here, we would still have to hook up to the 1040 grain cart to keep things moving along. I was wrong. This grain cart kept up beautifully. So with the Kenzie 1421 over like the 1205s, which we'll talk about the numbering system here, which was one of the enhancements of this grain cart. So this is a very comparable to a 1205 grain cart. So what's some of the things that they've added to this new series here? Obviously they changed the numbering system here. So this actually reflects the actual bushels that are held in the grain cart. So this is a 1400 bushel grain cart. The two stands for the dual auger, which has a horizontal auger here and then the vertical auger there. And then one is the series number. Kenzie was having issues, and maybe some of you guys have actually gone out, looked for a 1200 bushel grain cart and were priced a 1205 or something like that, and you're like, well, that's a little bit higher than this 1200 bushel grain cart. Well, realistically, you were not pricing a 1200 bushel grain cart. You were actually pricing a 1400 bushel grain cart, comparing it to a 1200 bushel grain cart. So that's why they changed the numbering system on these grain carts. They went back to this box style unloading system here. This grain cart has the ability to unload at 750 bushels a minute. I've timed myself unloading into a semi. I loaded a semi in a minute and 50 seconds, I think is what it was. And I felt like with this tip spout design, you're in the horizontal plane with that semi, and I had great control. I was not worried about spilling at all. They added a grease bank for weekly service. Really speeds up the service time. There are still a few grease zerks that you have to hit independently, like the hanger bearings on the top and in a few other places. Our 1040 has row crop tires on it, so the dual walking tandem row crop tires. This grain cart obviously has tracks. Tracks are worth it. We didn't test where we tried to crack eggs. What you can do with the reduction in compaction, floating, tracks are what you should have on these grain carts. I think tracks are worth the money. I think that's what you should have on your grain carts. So actually on Kenzie's new 1121, which is an 1100 bushel grain cart, that looks oddly like the 1050 Harvest Commander. They actually give you the option to purchase it with wheels, and then later on down the road, you can actually upgrade it to tracks. What we had this year that we have never had is actually a scale system, which on our operation, my dad farms his acres, I farm my acres, and then my dad and I actually farm acres together. That scale system has come in handy to really be able to send loads to the grain bins like this one here behind us that actually has my grain and my dad's and I's grain combined into together to keep logs of where the grain goes. Yeah, you can keep track of your yields for crop insurance, but the harvest scale for us was more value in being able to hop from field to field and stay going to a consistent bin with different ownerships of grain. They redesigned the hose holder here. This upright right here kept all the hoses out of the PTO all season long. Along with adding these color-coded hose handles, Makes it easier to hook up, plus you can tell which remotes go in what. And all you need for this grain cart is the two remotes. Stylization wise, they added the Kinzieman back to the back. Clean out dumps along the bottom side of the grain cart. That'd be really useful for people that do things like seed beans and they have to have a really clean grain cart. We don't grow any seed beans, so we actually never operated the dump doors this year, but we're gonna operate them once my dad gets up here for you guys. So your two hydraulics on this grain cart, one of them is for the fold of the auger, and then the other one you put into constant flow, which gives you control of the remote, which controls the spout and the tip down and up on this auger. So you have up and down control on the spout, which allows you to push the grain away from the semi if you want to, or pull it in towards you, or dump straight directly up and down, which is what I tried to do most of the time. Along with this cylinder right there that you can see, it will actually raise and lower the spout of the auger. And also on that remote is a big green button. When you hit that big green button, it actually engages the horizontal auger. When you turn the PTO on, which is a big 1000 PTO, it turns on the vertical auger only. So your vertical auger will be running when the PTO is on. Your horizontal auger only turns on when you hit the green button. And then on the back side of the remote, there's a trigger. And what that actually does is run your gate. As you can see, there's a gate indicator for the horizontal auger to open up to allow how much grain comes through. And there's numbered 1 through 6. And then right down here is the indication to tell you if your horizontal auger is on or off. Through the PTO shaft, there are slip clutches that actually protect the drivetrain of the tractor. To say you got slugged up, it would actually slip this instead of hurting your tractor. So your tractor is protected pulling one of these grain carts. What have I come to love about this grain cart on our operation? The size of it. The size of it's really darn nice. Yes, I believe that you should have 1,000 or 1,100 bushels on to go to a semi, but what actually I've found to be a really big production increase is the fact that we can put 3 combine unloads onto this grain cart, which means that this grain cart heads to the front to load a truck, and the combine is completely empty at that point, and the grain cart has all the time to fill the capacity of the combine all the way back up to make it back to the combine, so the combine never has to stop. In really good corn, we could keep the combine running all day. It never have to stop. That was amazing. I really, really like the tracks. The tracks, in comparison to the row crop tires that we were using, in wet conditions, we would see the heaving. Even in between the combine tires with the tracks, it flat floated right across the top. Especially pairing this track carrying cart with the track tractor, that worked pretty good. The other thing I really came to like is actually the reach of the auger. You don't have to be super close to a semi truck, where when we're running the 1040 grain cart, I mean, the semi would have to be about right here to load. This one, you'd be amazed how far away you can actually be from the semi and still get grain onto the semi. Okay, I've done my review. So after a season with the 1421, what are your opinions?
It's a class cart, nice cart.
But what did you notice that stood out about this?
Oh, the larger capacity and the unloading systems significantly faster, like 2-3 times faster. And the tracks, less compaction in the scale, allowed us to do a lot of things with mixing grain in one bin, and getting trucks loaded efficiently with the size loads that we wanted and things like that. So just cool.
Jumping from the 1040 grain cart in here, and you didn't run the grain cart too much this year, but how did you feel? How fast did you get used to using it, do you feel? Was it easy to learn?
Oh yeah, yeah, there's nothing too tough about it at all. It was like, just push the start button on the scale and the stop button on the scale. It tells you how much you unloaded, and the joystick controls for the dump thing where it comes out of the auger is easy to raise and lower the auger, and turn the horizontal auger on and off. Just nothing too tough about that.
A little bit of grace room too, the fact that you have the ability to adjust the auger. You know, with the 1040, it's going to dump in one spot and you got to get closer or either further away with the grain cart. This one, you have the ability to kind of air a little bit one side or the other and still be able to load the truck efficiently.
Yeah, because it always seems like when you're pulling along the truck, you're either getting closer to the truck or further away from the truck. And so when you're unloading with a cart that doesn't have the ability to adjust where it's going in the truck at, that just unevenly loads a truck. With this one, you can load a truck evenly, even though you're going away from the truck or getting closer to it. You can still put it right down the middle of the truck where you want it.
What about like the visibility when you're loading it from the combine? Good visibility into the cart, you know, big targets and stuff like that. It's not hard to load this on the go.
No, I have missed a cart in the past, but I did not miss this cart.
No. We're going to do the dump doors on the back since we've never done these yet. And it has a sweep in the bottom of it too. Still a bit of grain in there. Do you feel like a grain cart like this would be a good investment for an operation? Help speed up harvest and all things along those lines. You feel a grain cart, 1400 bushels in capacity, on tracks, high unload speeds, is a good investment?
It just has to depend on how many acres you're running and everything else, but generally speaking, most probably it would be for ours. I know that.
Yes, for ours. Impressed?
Oh yeah.
Impressed.
Yeah, impressed.
So we gotta say thank you for Kinsey to sending us this grain cart this fall.
Special thanks to Susan.
Yep.
And a special thanks to Justin and their engineering department that came out multiple times.
Yep.
And helped us along with it and checked things out, and
It was just a great experience all around. In between going, touring the factory, going to the media days, any questions we had, Justin was right there. They answered the questions. They brought down the engineers. What they say about, you know, it being a family-owned operation, a family-owned company, the fact that they actually do take advice from the end users is true. They want the feedback from the customers on how to continually improve the product they bring to you guys. So thank you again. And yes, so with that, our time with the 1421 is done. I don't think it's the last Kinsey product you guys will see show up here on the farm, because I know my future investments will be in Kinsey products. I really hope you guys enjoyed this grain cart. I really hope you guys enjoyed seeing it around all fall. I know I enjoyed using it all fall. I know I enjoyed the productivity that it gave to us all fall. Again, thank you to Kinsey. We'll see you guys in the next one. Oh yeah, my favorite nickname that someone came up with it for the year was Blutiful. I tried to call it the Cart Father, but it didn't ever really stick.